Hey you, welcome to Make for Others, where we make all kinds of stuff with all kinds of tools, and surprise, all kinds of people. I'm Dave, and this is a battery-powered, edge-lit standing picture frame that doesn't require any special skills or expensive tools to make. Seriously, it's one of the birthday presents for my awesome father-in-law, and you can see that whole story and his reaction here. The other present was a wall-mounted, battery-powered, backlit picture frame built from scratch. And you can check out that build video here. But anyway, let's get back to this guy, which took maybe an hour to build after I had all my supplies assembled. And speaking of supplies, there's affiliate links down in the description for everything that you're gonna need if you wanna make this on your own. The only thing not in the list is the picture, because I figured you'd wanna pick your own picture anyway. This is a shadow box frame, which is helpful because with the shadow box frame, that allows you to be able to fit more LEDs on the inside sidewalls. With this one, I was able to get three rows of LEDs, which is great when you're doing edge lit lighting because all your light is coming from the sides, so you want it to be as strong as possible. The more LEDs, the brighter the light, the brighter the image, the better it looks. With this particular shadow box frame, what I really liked about it is it opens in the front and the back, and that made it really easy to get everywhere. There wasn't any kind of awkwardness about getting to the front stuff through the back, or it made things a lot easier. I used a small flathead screwdriver to gently take out the supports holding that front glass. And before I was able to do that, I also had to use some pliers and pull out the nails to get the glass out of the way. And even if you can get the glass out without having to take the nails out, you're gonna wanna take those out anyway for future steps. Once you get that glass out, you're either gonna wanna keep it, and that's the thing that you're gonna put your image or your picture or you're gonna paint on or whatever you wanna do. Or if you're like me and you're gonna use something else, you're still gonna wanna measure it to know the exact size of it, because that's gonna be the perfect size for whatever you're gonna put in that space. I couldn't save the nails, so I pulled those out and got rid of them. I wasn't gonna reuse the glass, but I was gonna reuse the supports that were behind the glass. Those were already perfectly sized and fit in great. So I set those aside, and we'll get back to those later. Once the front was done, I took the back of the frame out, and I wanted to get rid of the cloth and the foam that my shadow box came with so that I could make more space on the inside so that there'd be more space for LEDs to go onto the sides. So you don't have to use a spatula, but I just found that that was easier to get all that stuff off, and it kept that cardboard back. There's less lumps, there's less bumps, and it made for a much smoother surface on the back part of the frame for future steps. Once that was done, I put the backing back into the frame and then marked a hole that was big enough for the LED cord to go through. And I centered it in the bottom because I wanted to keep the cords and the battery and everything else as hidden as much as possible. I cut that hole out carefully and then covered the back with aluminum tape. That aluminum tape is reflective and easy to put on, and I like it because it reflects the light from the LEDs. And with that, it'll make the light brighter, and it'll also even it out, because with edge lighting, you've got all the light sources on the sides. With the aluminum tape reflecting the whole back, that kind of evens out the light, so you don't just have like an edge of lighting. You've got, it looks like it's, the light is coming from the whole back. And then once the aluminum tape is done, then I recut the hole that the cord was gonna go through. I put the back into the frame. From there, I started attaching the LEDs to the sides with the goal of having as many rows of LEDs as possible. You can tell in some of the parts of the LEDs aren't completely flat on the sides, but they are secured to each other. And because they're, in some areas, they're laying on each other a little bit, I was able to fit an extra row of LEDs into it. Once I was close to running out of room, I cut the LED strip on one of the designated lines so that there wouldn't be any dead LEDs. And depending on the strip that you get, every strip is a little bit different. Just pay attention to the directions that it comes with. The thing I like about this corded LED is it's very clear where you're supposed to cut. And the nice thing about it already being corded is cutting it where you're supposed to cut it, that's the amount of electrical work you have to do. You know, there's no soldering, it's great. Then I double checked by plugging it in just to make sure everything was working. And then I covered up the back hole with electrical tape just to make sure there wouldn't be any light spill in the back. And to stop the cord moving around, I wanted to make sure that if there was anything that would pull on that cord, that it would pull on the tape and it wouldn't be pulling on the LEDs that were inside. I wanted to reduce any strain on those LEDs. Because I wanted everything connected, I put some Velcro on the back of the frame and the power bank so that could be attached to one another. Because if somebody picks it up off a shelf or whatever, I didn't want the power bank getting dropped or being drug off a shelf. I wanted to make sure that everything was connected. With all that extra cord, I strapped it together just so it would be easier to manage, because I didn't want to cut it, because then I'd have to solder. And if you like the power bank like I do, great. But if you don't like the idea of a power bank and you do have an outlet nearby, that cord is easily long enough that you can plug it into an outlet with an adapter. It just depends on how long you want to have the photo on. I had my photo back printed onto acrylic, and I like the way it looks all the time. Like, if the light's on, it looks good. If the light's off, it looks good. It looks good constantly. Harlan Graphics is the company that printed it for me, and if you want, there's a link in the description to them. They print and ship all over the place, and this isn't an affiliate link or anything like that. I just think they did a really good job with my photo, and they're good people. So once the picture was placed, I used some double-sided carpet tape to put the supports back. I like how easy to cut and thin this, and permanent. It's also very strong. I like how it's going to keep these supports where they need to be. And that was it. I'm really happy with how long this power bank lasts, but if it's something where you want to keep this light on all the time, every day, then I would recommend plugging it into an outlet. The nice thing is, if you build it this way, if you're near an outlet, you can plug it into an outlet. If you're not near an outlet, you can use it with the power bank. So what I like about this specific power bank is that there's an on-off switch on one side. So two for off, one for on. That's it. Really easy. No electrical, no wiring, no nothing, just it's all built in. Now it's ready to enjoy. I hope you watching this video has encouraged you to want to try and make something for someone else. And I'd love to hear in the comments what you're going to do. You can watch the whole birthday surprise project and my father-in-law's reaction here, or watch something YouTube thinks you'll like here.